that year. And the Navy grabbed onto that, and within another year after that, we were shot and shoot on Navy ships down at San Diego, and ultimately, I think the Four Seas and the Navy invited us to shoot on a carrier at sea.
The military loves JAG. They love to make fun of it a little bit because it's obviously heightened reality, and they love to give you a little punch in the arm, but at the same time, really appreciate that we portray the military in a really positive light.
The military were so great. The people that I met and spoke with and got letters from just loved the show. They loved the characters we played. They really, you know, of course, every once in a while someone would say, you know, your ribbons were a little, you know, and your skirt was a little too short or too tight, or, you know, there was always some of those notes. But for the most part, people really enjoyed how we represented them. I think it was in a positive light.
In the second year of the show, Crossing the Line is a show that I absolutely love.
Who are you?
Crossing the Line was one where there was a female aviator, and was she being using her sex to accuse someone of harassment, or was she just not a good pilot?
The CAG doesn't approve of women in combat, so my failure would prove him right.
And you got the real issue that I thought the JAG handled very well of discrimination in the military. Can a woman fly as well? And is there a problem with the fact that she is not treated as fairly? All of that was dealt with, I think, excellently in the episode.
The main thing is, I don't want to do anything that'll hurt the Navy. I just want the same chance as the others.
You know, because it was real and it was relevant, and whether it was sexual harassment, I mean, that was happening, and we would definitely confront it head on.
Did you instruct Master Chief Sullivan to cause Lieutenant Isaacs to be groped, poked with a pitchfork, and or verbally abused during the Crossing the Line ceremony?
Now, why the hell would I do that?
That's what we're here to find out, sir.
Our writers and producers would always show, I guess, all sides. You know, it was, yes, maybe we would take a side, you know, but ultimately we were able to explore the different, you know, issues that were really going on, and hopefully let the audience decide for themselves what they thought.
But the show, you know, the show was trying to, we were trying to be topical, and we were.
Sir, the skipper requests Commander Rabb and Major McKenzie in the wardroom, sir.
Very well. Dismissed.
I remember Crossing the Line mainly for the introduction of Harriet and Bud's romance.
May I?
May what?
Well, your insignia is, I don't know if that's a red light.
Straightening my insignia?
It's so hard to know what appropriate behavior is sometimes, you know, red light, green light.
Just straighten the damn thing, sir.
Patrick and I ended up having a good time, and I think the camera sort of saw that. Like, we sort of clicked together, and because Bud and Harriet ended up being sort of the comedic quality to the show, I think it just sort of worked a little bit.
Wow. What JAG lawyers do is so exciting.
I'm not a lawyer yet.
I know. But you're going to be a great one.
Everybody wanted Bud and Harriet to end up together and stay together, and we were the family unit that managed to make it, you know. And I used to laugh and say that Bud and Harriet are the only ones getting any, because we were the only ones having 45 babies, and then Mac and Harm couldn't make it work, and then so-and-so and so-and-so couldn't get together, and so-and-so broke up, and so-and-so died, and da-da-da. And Bud and Harriet just keep making babies and making babies. But it was kind of a fine line, because I don't think, it's like your parents. You know they kissed, and you know that you're here because something else happened, but you don't really want to talk about it. I think that's kind of Bud and Harriet's story.
Well, defending Western civilization makes people horny.
I'm sorry, how embarrassing.
Two favorite episodes from the season. One is Secrets, which I thought was a terrific performance by everyone involved.
Admiral, aren't you going to defend me?
If you don't like my defense, get yourself another lawyer.
And had a lot of tension in it, because it's about a young man who is imprisoned wrongly in his mind, and he forces his trial court-martial to be held over with Chedwigan and Mac and Harm, conducting it at the point of a gun, of course, in